were there in the morning and you heard Sanjeeva's introduction to WSO2Telco. And really this presentation is a little bit more detail on WSO2Telco, the product, and also a little bit more background on how it came to being. Essentially, the businesses that were built around it, the technology that was built around it to support those businesses, and of course, finally, the WSO2 product itself. So, first slide. Excuse me. It always happens, right? Always happens. I'll just put that on. Okay, so I'm going to start with talking about IdeaMart, which is perhaps the most mature developer engagement API product that we have in Dialog. So it's been running for about 2 years now. It's targeting long tail. It's been immensely successful. It's got essentially two variants in how the product works. The first one, Idea Pro, is essentially a series of REST APIs. We've got about 10 APIs that enable long-tail developers to build applications on top of various Dialog infrastructure. Then we've got Idea Apps. Now, Idea Apps is a more advanced, or I guess a more simplified service creation environment where developers can quickly create applications in minutes. And finally, the third product there, All Apps, is about publishing those applications and services on a store and making it accessible to Dialog's customer base. So those are the products. That's the engagement. So generally, in the last 18 months, we've run nearly 100 outreach programs. So outreach programs are engagements in universities and schools, et cetera, right across the country in Sri Lanka. We've run 11 hackathons. And we engage in various special interest groups. We engage with the venture community in Sri Lanka around finding funding for these small companies in Sri Lanka. So all in all, there's almost as much emphasis in this developer engagement program as there is in the technology piece. So what has this produced? So well, what this has produced is right up there, we are very proud of that. So we got a global award for technology enabler at GSMA just a few months ago. And really what's driven that are those numbers. So very powerful. So over 4,000 apps and services deployed so far. Nearly 2,500 developers engaging on the platform. And critically, you know, 200 plus traffic growth over the last 6 months. And this has actually translated to a consistent 20% month-on-month growth. So big numbers. And to a large extent, I think, across the world, one of the most successful long-tail developer programs. So IdeaBiz, the second product, not as mature. We only launched it in February. So this is, again, an API product targeting trusted service providers and enterprises. And this is about building a marketplace in Sri Lanka. So Dialog will publish its telco APIs. At the same time, other software providers can publish their own APIs. Dialog then carries out the settlement on behalf of those service providers. So again, it's about exposing APIs, monetizing those APIs, using Dialog as a channel to market. And then on the other side, it's about consuming those APIs and building services, just like IdeaMart has done so successfully with Longtail. So what I have here is a case study. Now, this is about trying to emphasize the power of the platform and the impact it can bring. So the way this worked was, it was a marketing campaign put together by Unilever, marketing a local brand called Sunlight. So Vesak is a festival in Sri Lanka which is about writing lamps. So Unilever ran a campaign about, you know, sunlight, bringing light to the country. So the way it worked was, you would give a call to a number promoted. This would in turn generate an SMS saying, we have received your call. which is call number X. And on Vesak Day, there was a foot, a 9 foot by 100 foot large video display, and a lamp would light up with your number. So again, this was a campaign to do with mobile interaction, to do with people physically being present there. So now, this is not something new. It's a relatively simple concept. But the difference is that critically, it was put together in 3 days. So if you put together a telco service that's handling missed calls, sending SMSs, talking to a wall, that's not something you can do in 3 days. It's actually, you're looking at, you know, 8 months. What enabled this was the API ecosystem that was exposing Dialog's network components. So another case study, Mobile Connect in Sri Lanka. So I think the operators or telco vendors in the room must be familiar with Mobile Connect. I'm not going to talk about it too much. I think Steve will talk about it in more detail, if I can spot Steve. There he is. He's the man, Mobile Connect man. And again, the example here was how we executed Mobile Connect in Sri Lanka. Again, this was put together in a matter of weeks in Sri Lanka. Based on the power of the WSO2Telco platform, there were two operators, Dialog and Mobitel, both using the WSO2 stack. And back then, it was just the identity server. But within a short time, we could put enough together to facilitate a proof of concept demo across two mobile operators, three service providers, and initially 200 users, then 1,000, and now a full commercial launch. So again, that was the first commercial launch of Mobile Connect in the world, built on top of this platform. So, and again, another award for that identity offering at the European Identity and Cloud Awards, based on that solution. Okay, so I've talked to you about a couple of products in Dialog, the business impact of those, what we've done. So that technology was essentially built on top of the WSO2 core stack. So what happened next was, so Dialog is just one operator in the Asiata group. What happened next was, the same technology has now gone to the wider Asiata group, and it turned into a group API project. So it's the same concept, and I've used the same terms that were used in some other presentations in case people are familiar with MIFE. So we've got the Asiata operators there, Celcom, XL, Dialog, Robi, and Smart. Each individual opcos their own mechanisms for engaging with service providers locally. So what we've got is a combination of gateways. So as I mentioned before, I've used the term MIFE because in previous presentations, the WSO2Telco platform stack was often referred to as MIFE. So I've used the same term here because this is what we refer to it in Asiata. So we are looking at a series of API and identity gateways in some operators, and in four of the operators there. And on the fifth operator, we are looking at a third-party API gateway. Again, this doesn't impact the architecture because we define an outbound API exposure for each of these operators. So we've defined payment, SMS, location, and of course, Mobile Connect for identity. So what we've done here is we've essentially aggregated those APIs into a single hub, a single integration point that is managed by the Asiata group. So this is a single point for a single central onboarding point for service providers, a central onboarding point for the legal contractual piece, and of course, for settlement, etc. So what this has meant is that you then start to expose all the features that I described earlier with IdeaMart that we only saw in Sri Lanka in a local context, regionally now. So this regional hub for Asiata can start to target regional e-commerce players. They can start to target regional enterprises, etc. So this software is essentially developed by Asiata, serving Asiata business needs, has been turned into or donated back to WSO2 as WSO2Telco. So this software will be productized, and right now we are looking at making it more generic to be more applicable beyond the Asiata market, the country. And it's using a number of core WSO2 components. So we've got API manager, identity server, CEP, BAM, business process server, and of course the ESP for doing those integrations. As mentioned, we've customized these components to meet telco requirements. We haven't rewritten things. As much as possible, we have written extensions. The idea being that if WSO2 releases a new version of API Manager, hopefully in a matter of weeks, we will be able to support a WSO2 telco API Manager with those same features, but bringing in the new features from the API Manager roadmap. So in terms of solutions, as I mentioned before in the previous slide, we've distilled this solution down into two components, two key components. One, the telco hub, essentially to support, I will actually talk about those two in more detail in the next couple of slides, actually. So again, to emphasize, I mentioned a little bit of this in the slide about Asiata and why Asiata put together a group hub. So essentially, the reason we did it in dialogue was because we wanted to engage with partners faster. Instead of spending, 8 months launching a service, we wanted to do it in weeks. It's not about, spending 8 months and launching a product to market that fails, but it's about launching a product in weeks. It's about launching campaigns like the Unilever campaign in days. So the cost of failure is low. You can innovate more, you can iterate. So the whole objectives around building this stack is about building a tool where an operator can actually start to be a digital services player. Okay, step one is actually partnering and engaging with digital service players. So this stack is really to try and hit that sweet spot. So I mentioned earlier the two products. So this is a more detailed breakdown. I'm not going to read through it in a lot of detail, the whole list. But essentially, what we have in the telco hub is a fully featured API manager with existing adapters for standard-based telco interfaces. So SMPP, SS7, et cetera, et cetera, diameter. There's a bunch of network adapters, plug and play, ready to go, that will enable northbound exposure as GSMA 1 API. And of course, there's a whole bunch of suite of products to support integration of non-standard interfaces. There's also a series of very powerful dashboards and analytics targeting API monetization usage around a telco and running a business around that. So very critical component is the charging models that have been developed specifically. So we've got a bunch of charging models from tier-based API charging, per transaction charging, per unique subscription charging, all built into this stack. The idea being an operator, depending on which APIs they want to expose, they can plug in one of these charging mechanisms, and they've got a mechanism to generate relevant charging reports. The hub has the capability to produce charging reports for multiple operators. So a hub would be where multiple operators are plugged in. So it's got a reporting capability to generate those settlement reports for multiple operators. And talking a little bit more about the telco gateway. So the telco gateway is a flavor of the product targeting an individual opco. So while a telco hub is focusing on a group or an aggregator hub, the gateway is about a local operator. So this is really the situation where a local operator wants to manage their own ecosystem. They do their own onboarding of service providers, et cetera. And a very critical component of that service is the ACR module. So this module enables anonymizing traffic, etc. So in a situation where you got data protection, data privacy laws in country, you're integrating to a group hub, etc., this would be the layer that would prevent data going outside the country. So this slide gives you a little bit more of a view of how these two components fit together in the wider ecosystem. So we are talking about a regional hub, essentially built up based on the WSO2Telco hub, capable of integrating multiple regional operators. So in a country like could be integrating multiple Indian operators. In Sri Lanka, it's integrating the incumbent operators in Sri Lanka. What would then happen is operator groups within that ecosystem could plug into this same regional hub. Essentially, what we are looking to do is grow an ecosystem. So you're looking at a regional hub in one country, you're looking at a country hub in another, and a group working across all of these. Given the API integration layer powered by the ESB and also using GSMA 1 API for integrations, the idea is about interoperability. So one of the experiences that we've had in Sri Lanka, we've had a very successful API monetization program. However, it's been single operator. It's been dialogue only. When we started doing things like Mobile Connect that were multi-operator, we immediately saw a huge uplift. So this is really building this ecosystem is really about trying to get to other operators, growing the ecosystem, and truly competing with OTT players. And to a large extent, this is why Aziata has made this open source, because we want more operators doing this. We want more operator groups doing this. And frankly, this is the only way an operator can work effectively with an OTT and still remain relevant in a fast-changing world. So this is a more detailed view of Mobile Connect. So I've put GSMA Mobile Connect. Again, the WSO2Telco MCX platform is a very important component of the WSO2Telco stack that's been certified by GSMA as a Mobile Connect provider. So essentially what we've got there is out-of-the-box components that are integrated to GSMA Exchange for extended support of their light integrations or their commercial integration models. We've got built-in adapters that will support SMS and USSD authenticators. And of course, a framework to rapidly build more of these authenticators. So again, a little bit more detail about the Mobile Connect service offering. Again, I want to emphasize the out-of-box support for authenticators. Now, again, I appreciate this is probably a bit difficult if you haven't looked at Mobile Connect in detail. But essentially what it means is you have got a level of assurance or level of assurance security too that is essentially a test of what you have with you. So it's essentially testing whether you've got a device with you. So whether it be a USSD click OK, whether it be a seamless nogging using network head enrichment. An LOA3, a higher security level of assurance, where you're looking at a USSD pin prompt or a SIM applet, etc. So there is essentially testing something you have and something you know. So that's my contact details and a link to more information about the product. But let me just summarize very quickly. So WSO2Telco, a product that's been built by a telco for telcos. So we've really understood the problems telcos have. We've tested it in market. And we've leveraged the power of I don't have to tell people here because you are already WSO2 customers or understand the power of the platform. So it's essentially leveraging the power of the WSO2Telco platform and bringing telcos to a position that we can engage with partners more effectively, compete with OTT providers more effectively. Essentially, make an operator a digital services player.